Ông quay chỗ. Ông chúng mình đã phát cả một tổ cái tham gia can tế thị tham gia cả. Rồi số đấy lục xã xây, tế lục bàn triêm khuôn rồi hai rừng nữ.
Thank you, Mr. President. Yes, good morning again, Mr. Witness. We were speaking before the break about Tarin,
Heng Samrin.
And my question to you was whether he was one of the commanders involved in the evacuation of Phnom Penh on the 17th of April 1975.
Was he? នៅ ថ្ងៃ 17 មេសា 1975 ដែរ ឬ
ប៉ត បាន ចូល រួម ឯ សម្រាប់ ជិះចឹង ពី ក្រុង ភ្នំ ពេញ តាម មូល ការ គ្រប់ ណា
And is it correct that you at the time were a courier and that you brought messages to him, messages presumably from the rear front to the battlefront, is that correct? And who was the commander of Heng Samrin who ordered or who sent instructions to Tarin during the evacuation? Do you know whether there was also another military superior to Heng Samrin at the time of the evacuation and also subsequently, someone who was called Kiu Samnang?
Kiu Samnang.
Let me ask it differently. When you talked about Tarin in your DCCAM statement, you said I was a courier and Heng Samrin was on, quote, the supreme general staff side of things for moving ammunition, supplying ammunition. That is page 82, Mr. President. French ERN 01348540 and Khmer 01340497. Mr. Witness, was Tarin or Heng Samrin a member of the Supreme General Staff responsible for supplying ammunition during the evacuation and also thereafter? Mr. Witness, maybe you didn't hear my question. Let me rephrase it and make it easier. Was Heng Samrin a member of the Supreme General Staff of the East Zone responsible for supplying ammunition
during the evacuation អាវុធយុទ្ធភណ្ឌផ្សេងៗ តើអញ្ចឹង ឬក៏ យ៉ាង ណា
Thank you for the clarification and
just to make sure
do you know whether the direct chief on the general staff
in other
words the zone military chairman was someone named Kiu Samnang And what do you remember about Khao Samnang? Did you know him personally at the time as well?
No, pe nu ta lok skol kot chbas te.
Kot chbang Samnang phuong hen trop sing tru le kot ta.
In your statement, you say indeed that you know that you knew him, that Khao Samnang was both the Vision 2 commander and member of the Supreme General Staff.
On
English page 80,
Khmer
013404495, French 013485539, you said that the Supreme General Staff of the Zone was at
Senatica
the time in Prey Veng. Is that correct?
Prey Veng, Tram Trao Dai Rute.
And did you go to Prey Veng delivering also messages from
Saopim to Kiu Samnang?
Let's talk a bit more about Division 4. Do you know who at the time were the deputy commanders of Division 4? Do the names Kri or Chun mean anything to you?
Kri,
K-R-Y, Chun, C-H-H-O-E-U-N.
Did
you know Kri?
ចំណេញនៅខាងក្រៅឲ្យពួកឲ្យខាងបងរិទ្ធទៅប្រែប៉ះស្ដាប់បាទហើយសម្រាប់រត់នេះមកកុំឲ្យមានបញ្ហាសុំគេទៅណាសុំគេមករយៈពេលនេះទៅកុំឲ្យមានបញ្ហារំខានអញ្ចឹងបញ្ជីបន្តទៀត
Thank you Mr. President to speed up things Mr. Witness let me read to you a small excerpt from W.R.I. from the other East Zone military person. This E3/517, English year end 0037580, Khmer 0037-3441, French 0042634-8. This witness speaks about Division 4.
សាស្ត្រាចារ្យរូបនេះនិយាយអំពីកងពលលេខ4.
And he says the following, and I will read slowly.
រៀបរាប់ដូចតទៅខ្ញុំសូមអានឲ្យលោកស្ដាប់យឺតយឺតទេ.
In Division 4,
នៅក្នុងកងពលលេខ4,
Rik Pham deceased because the Angkar arrested him.
រីកផាននេះគឺស្លាប់ហើយដោយសារអង្គការបានចាប់ខ្លួនគាត់.
Heng Samrin alive was the deputy chief.
ហេងសំរិនគឺនៅរស់នៅឡើយហើយគាត់គឺជាអន
ុ
មេបញ្ជាការកងពលលេខ4. គ្រីជាសមាជិកកងពលលេខ4. មិនដឹងថាសពថ្ងៃនេះគាត់នៅរស់ឬក៏ស្លាប់ហើយទេ.
Approximately more than a year after 17 April, Pham was arrested.
ក្រោយថ្ងៃ17 មេសា 75 ខណ្ឌក៏ត្រូវបានចាប់ខ្លួនហើយហេងសំរិនគាត់ក៏បានឡើងធ្វើជាមេបញ្ជាការ.
It is unknown whether he is alive or dead was the
deputy. មិនដឹងថាគាត់ស្លាប់ឬក៏រស់ទេដែលជាអនុមេបញ្ជាការនោះ.ហើយគ្រីនៅតែជាសមាជិក
របស់ដែរ died in late 78.
ជឿននេះគឺជាសមាជិកហើយក្រោយមកក៏ស្លាប់នៅក្នុងឆ្នាំចុងឆ្នាំ
78. I mentioned some names.
លោកសាក់សៃខ្មានលើក
ឈ្មោះ commander
មួយចំនួនយកមកសួរលោកនេ
ះ
អតីតមេបញ្ជាការកងពលលេខ4នឹងគឺឈ្មោះផានតើលោកស្គាល់ដែរឬទេ
លោកផានស្គាល់
Just to be sure, let me ask my national colleague to pronounce the
Made
name.
Made away, but the way I chop up each morning, some of his hakari chit rubok nyom, got a lan an chmuh ni hoi luk sdap.
Ba, some at nhà luk thiên, got chmuh. Ba, got គាត់ឈ្មោះរាជផនរាជផនហើយនឹងឈ្មោះក្រីណារាជផនហើយនឹងឈ្មោះក្រី
Hello, Mr. Witness, are you there?
មេធាវីលោកសាក់សីមិនទៅលោកស្ដាប់ឮទេ
ស្ដាប់ឮហើយខ្ញុំអត់ស្គាល់
That's no problem. Mr. Witness, do you know
Heng Samrin's
younger brother,
who was also a division commander,
Tal?
Got Chiem Mae Mechia Ka Kong Pol Dai, got Chmuh Tal, look Skol Te?
Tal got Skol Dai. Tom Dai Lik Chmuh Pok. Tom Dai Lik Chmuh Pok.
Mr. Witness, you spoke about Darin, whom you knew closely even from before 1975. Did you often meet him after 1975 while you were
Sopim's
driver and
bodyguard? How did you meet him after 1975?
Would you have conversations with Darin?
Su cho lok men ban nyei chmuoy nang Darin te.
Man dai nai ban nyei ke. Kon ka su kon mok. Nyom dai nyei mot ra kon.
Mr. Witness, I would like to show you a photo. And after having shown the photo to you, I would like to ask you if you know who this person is. We can also put it on the screen here. It is a still from the documentary E3/0.15R, a still of the footage at 1:53,
and
hopefully at the same time the duty council will be in a position to show that particular photo.
សង្ឃឹមថាមេធាវីប្រឹក្សាក៏អាចនឹងជួយបង្ហាញទៅដល់រូបថតនេះផងដែរបាទអញ្ចឹងមិនអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យសូមចាក់ផ្សាយនៅលើអេក្រង់ទូរទស្សន៍តាមសម្រាប់មេធាវីហើយនឹងមេធាវីប្រឹក្សាសាក់សីសូមលោកជួយបង្ហាញរូបថតនោះទៅដល់សាក់សីដើម្បីពិនិត្យនិងអាចឆ្លើយតបនឹងសំណួរបាន
Mr. Witness, let me show 10 seconds of that actual video clip.
Maybe
after having seen that part of the video with the same person, you might recognize this person.
This person with your leave,
9 seconds from that very same video, E3/0.15R. We can put it on the screen and hopefully the duty council will guide his client to have a look at the screen when we show this video. Mr. Witness, were you able to see on your screen
the video we just played?
That's all right. One last photo before I move on to another subject. Mr. President, I would like to show a photo that we have showed to other witnesses before, E3/0.259, English ERN P0416559. Mr. Witness, please have a look at this photo and see if you recognize anyone.
រូបថតនេះមើលតើលោកអាចនៅចងចាំបានដែរឬទេបាទហើយលោកមេធាវីជួយបង្ហាញសាក់សីឲ្យហើយរូបថតឲ្យសាក់សីពិនិត្យហើយខាងសោទស្សន៍ចាក់ផ្សាយរូបថតនៅលើអេក្រង់ទូរទស្សន៍ផង
Mr. Witness, Mr. Witness, who are, do you know, do you recognize anyone in this photo?
Look, sa say ta look men skol neak na mneak no knong rup thot ni dai te.
Na skol mneak.
And who is it that you know?
Mai te wei, chos mneak dai look skol nang ta chi neak na.
And who is that? Who is Sao Pim? Can you describe where he's standing on the photo? And Mr. Witness, do you recognize the person left of him who is also wearing the krama and who is also smiling? Do you know that person? The person that's standing left of Sao Pim, is that someone who looks like a person you mentioned frequently in your
DC camp statement, Nuon Chia?
That's no problem.
To
discuss one last person, someone that you also mentioned in your DC camp statement,
a brother of Darin,
Heng Samkai. Do you remember Heng Samkai?
តើ លោក នៅ ចាំ ឬ ក៏ ស្គាល់ ហេង សំកៃ ដែរ ឬ ទេ
ហេង សំកៃ ហ្នឹង មិន ស្គាល់ ប៉ុន្តែ លោក គាត់ ក្លា ហើយ
I understand but
maybe ខ្ញុំ យល់
ហើយ before May 78 what was the position of ហេង សំកៃ
តើ ហេង សំកៃ មាន តួ នីតិ អ្វី ដែរ
What was he in fact the chief of the courier's office in the East Zone?
Ta kot ku chea prathean munti nerasa samrap phumuphea bopea ru?
Ta.
Did you send messages from Sao Pim to Heng Samkai? Do you know whether Sao Pim had frequently contact with Heng Samkai?
Ta lok dang tha Sao Pim mien ban teak tuong khne chmuoy nang Heng Samkai nyuk nyop dai rue te?
Man tau te. Tau mo. Tro mien ka wom. Tan cham bat.
Um, Thank you, Mr. Witness. Now let's move to
a very important
date in the
East Zone.
Events that took place on 25th of May 1975. Do you recall what happened on the 25th of May 1978? Let me ask it differently. What happened in the 2 weeks before Sopin died on the 3rd of June
1978? Khai Usuphia 78 ta lok dang thế tha vi mien prittika avai kaot laeng
mien pat na ka pai mok nia ke chap nu ke chap ko pong kia cha ta kum lak chao
let me Ask it more concretely. You talked about a coup d'etat and literally you said Pot made a coup d'etat and was killing people. In other words, the contemptible Pol Pot staged a coup d'etat and was killing people. Do you remember saying that to
these accounts?
Mr. Witness, you spoke to members of DC CAM only a year and a half ago on the 9th of July 2015. You gave many details about all kinds of events at the time. Are you afraid to speak in public? Mr. Witness, you spoke extensively about specifically, you said that there might have been a coup d'etat apparently by Pol Pot, and that Pol Pot was killing people and arresting people. Can you please tell us what you remember?
Lúc nó khơi như thế thì lúc bán cháu anh chẳng à?
Bà nhầm cháu anh chẳng mấy bà nhầm cháu anh biết mấy như bắt cao
Sorry for interrupting, but I remember we had this difficult with the word coup d'etat and what it means. May I just interrupt here? Witness, what's your definition of a coup d'etat? Because that's a French word. What does coup d'etat mean for you?
Coup d'etat means coup d'etat. Coup d'etat means coup d'etat.
รัฐทหารนั้นคือปลดปล่อยจับจีจวนจับของตอบจันทร์ของกระเพียบจับกระสินรับรัฐทหารเป็นปลด
Mr. Witness, not only you, but
I believe almost everyone from the former Isson who was interviewed after the 25th of May 78 spoke about a coup d'etat staged either by Pol Pot or by Son Sen. Now you said in your statement that it was Pol Pot who quote-unquote made a coup d'etat.
What did you mean with that when you said that to
DC Camp? I don't know if you were able to do this, but I don't know if Pol Pot who made a coup d'etat.
But wasn't it true that Pol Pot was in power at the time, that he was the Prime Minister, he was the Secretary of the CPK and the Standing Committee? How did you understand at the time that it was Pol Pot who staged a coup d'etat? Can you explain what you understood at the time?
Has he not just done that
when I asked him, or what additional measures did you do in order to clarify? Because it's obvious that the coup d'etat is used not necessarily in the way we would understand. So as for a definition
that he gave, as a matter of fact, I disagree with you, Judge Fens, because that word coup d'etat is used by everyone. It's used by Heng Samrin, it's used by Chiu Sin, it's used by every single person from the East Zone. And we all use the same word, and with the other witness 2 weeks ago, we verified that it is the same Khmer word.
I'm not questioning that they are using the word. I'm saying it's perhaps not necessarily what they mean when they use the word. That's why I asked him, what does it mean? And he said it means that Pol Pot was killing civilians and soldiers. I stopped there because that's obviously your job to go further.
Let me be very concrete, Mr. Witness. The grabbing or the taking of power. Why did you use that word? Why did you say that it was Pol Pot who staged a coup d'etat?
I thought Pol Pot was the one who staged a coup d'etat.
Let me ask it differently. Did you ever hear So Pim say to anyone, either in speeches or during meetings, that he believed it was either Pol Pot or Son Sen who staged a coup d'etat?
I didn't think that.
Mr. Witness, you were Sao Pim's bodyguard, driver. You just confirmed that Sao Pim went to visit Pol Pot in Phnom Penh often. Why are you saying now that you heard of Pol Pot's name?
Why are you seemingly afraid to speak about this?
Yang score, kalau mesti muka tak tahu. Kalau mahu rupanya, dia cuma.
Well, let me move away from that subject. And ask you just one or two more questions. Sao-pim's death. What do you mean with that? We haven't seen each other.
Ta luk min nei yom mai tha luk nige tha man ban khoeng khnie rohot da lai nung.
Nga ya khu dai li so chmo. Han dang ko thalap na ai nam yom man dang da. Pok ni hot ban tae chmo ni.
Mr. Witness, what happened after Sao-pim died on the 3rd of June 1978?
What did you do? Thai bay mitona chat bay ta karai nung ma ta luk thua vai ban to tiet.
Mr. Witness, if I were you, I would do the same thing, giving answers like this. But isn't it true that you, in fact, after Sao-pim's death, with others, created an army of at least 200-300 persons
established to fight back against the Central Force.
So, please tell us about the creation of these strong forces, fighting back the center forces. What can you tell us about that? How many members were there? With whom did you fight? Can you please tell us?
Can you tell us about the creation of these strong forces, fighting back the center forces? What can you tell us about that?
Mr. Witness, let me read to you what you said to BC Camp. See if I can refresh your memory. E3/10717. Question: what sort of army was created? And then you answer: it was created in order to fend them off. Question: do you know how big an army was created at that time? Answer: we created it. question. How many divisions were you able to create? From where were the weapons and military equipment to be had? Answer. A division was not possible. We got 200 to 300 persons. Question. Was it Ta Sao Pim who created the army? No, not him. It was the defense unit there. The defense unit created it? Yes. Who led in its creation?
Cheng.
Mr. Witness, do you recall saying that to DC Cam?
ចាំតែថាលោកឆ្លើយនៅចម្លើយបែបនេះប្រាប់ប្រជាជនដល់ឯកសារកម្ពុជា
Mr. Witness, I just read back to you something you said to DC Cam about your division unit creating an army of 200 to 300 people to fight back against Pol Pot's forces. Do you recall saying that to DC Cam?
Yes, I recall saying that to DC Cam.
เรียนได้ในรอบเรียบของคณะนั้นในสมุดเขียนเรื่องอภิเษกเรียนจัดหนึ่งตามองออกเรียบเรียนเรียนพวกรถเนี้ยชอบต้องการเรียนปีบาร์แต่ที่จับเรียนรับแต่ให้เงินแม่ตามเรียนแม่เรียนนอนบ้านพวกเขียนเรียนพวกเรียนเรียนเรียนเรียน
Mr. Witness, weren't you in fact with the defense forces fighting together with a battalion called 09?
ដើម្បីវាប្រយ័ត្នវាប្រយុទ្ធជាមួយកងវរៈមួយដែលគេហៅថាកងវរៈសរុបមួយហ្នឹងមែនទេ?
What Biang Totum Pagoda, I hope I pronounce it well. Do you remember saying to DC Cam that fighting took place close to Suong as UONG at Wat Biang Totum Pagoda? Mr. Willis, is it correct that Battalion 09 played a very important role in the armed clashes between Eastern forces and Central forces? And if yes, is it correct that it was Mao Pok who was the commander of Battalion 09?
Mình coi đây, nó còn nè.
Mr. Ritters, you speak about Mao Pok in your DC-10 statement. This is what you said at that same page I just referred to, page 94. To whom did the 09s belong? And then you answered, to us, Easterners. Question. Das side answered, Da Pok side. Question. Da Mao Pok side? Yes. Were the 09 side and Da Sao Pim the same, they were together as one. And then you go on to speak about Da Mao Pok. Mr. Witness, does that refresh your memory?
Yes, I can remember the name Mao Pok.
What did Da Mao Pok do after 1979?
Do you know? Ta krai chnam
79 ta do you know whether he was arrested in 1982 by the Vietnamese?
Ta luk
That's fine, Mr. President. I have only 10 more minutes left. For this witness, but Not here with me. At the moment, I believe that witness himself in his statement indicated that Chil was the Sector 5 chairman. I believe Tot refers to Chil's position as Sector 5 chairman, not initially, I believe, but at a later stage, because he was first deputy. I'm happy to provide the relevant documents and EC numbers, if you allow me, after lunch break.
Yes, sure, that's tout à fait intéressant.
ขอบคุณให้บทตอนนี้ประกาศจุนเตอร์สะปริญญาทำไมมีโอกาสสวดอินดาวจิบุสะใส่รูปนี้ Good morning, Mr. Witness.
I'd
like to begin by asking you some questions about visits to the
East Zone by party leaders.
Is it correct that you told us that Pol Pot would come to visit the East Zone? I believe he didn't hear.
Let me rephrase the question.
Do you recall Pol Pot visiting the East Zone?
Do you recall Pol Pot
visiting
Okay, thank you. I understand that. Let me see if I can help your memory at all. I want to read to you a little bit what you said
to
DC CAM when you spoke to them. And this is at English 01355814. In Khmer, it's 01340522. And in French, 01348565. During that interview, the DC CAM person, Long Dani, asked you, did the top leaders like Pol Pot, Nguyen Chea, and others come to meet Thao Sao Phim in the East Zone or not? And you said they came quite often. Long Dani asked you who came often, and you said Nguyen Chea. Do you recall? First of all, let me stick with Pol Pot. Do you recall Pol Pot, the party leader, visiting the East Zone after the 1975 defeat of the Lon Nol Army? Thank you. And what about Nguyen Chea? Do you recall him visiting? Well, on the same page, you said that Nguyen Chea came to Samrong. You also came to Sung, to Samrong. And then you said he worked at Sung, Samrong, and Tu Priet. Does that refresh your recollection at all? Okay, well, let me switch topics then for now. Excuse me, one more person I want to ask you about. You also told DC CAM that you saw Ing Sari and Khieu Sampong. Do you remember seeing Ing Sari and Khieu Sampong? And the reference English 0135516, French 0134856767, Khmer 0134052. Do you recall saying, sir, that one could say you saw those like Pol Pot, Kyusampan, and Ing Sariya come there frequently? How often did they come? That was the question to you. And you said sometimes two or three times per year. Do you recall seeing Kyusampan or Ing Sariya in the East Zone? When these top leaders would come to the East, how did Sao Pim treat them?
Sao Pim thua yang doi mà đách đạo mê đặc nôm tình hòa nô.
Phật khơi ngó Phật chạp đầy ao
I see, thank you. And would these top leaders come with whole armies or a few bodyguards? About how many people did they bring with them? How many armed security?
Do công cà phê rồi do sản xuất sốc mà trở lại bên bên nào đấy mà ta sản xuất sốc bị bệnh tế rồi còn miền công sản xuất trở lại nè mà chụp mùi
nhìn chàng thế buồn tạm nè còn con đọc nè vẫn nè tạm còn.
Thank you. I want to talk to you about the arrests of people in the East Zone. Do you recall when those arrests began, when you first became aware that East Zone people were being arrested?
Do you recall when those arrests began, when you first became aware that East Zone people were being arrested?
Do you recall when it was that Sao Pim started to become concerned about these arrests? I ask you because you said this during your interview in 2015, and your honor, this is from English 0135578, French 0134854545, and Khmer 0134050501. You said that only after the last wave, first I'll give you the question. You were asked by Long Dani, what about the constant stream of many arrests that were being made in the sectors in the army? Surely he would have known that he also would be arrested. And you answered, only after that last wave of arrests did it dawn on him, did he realize he would be arrested. Do you recall that, sir, first of all, that there were waves of arrests, different waves of arrests in the East
Zone?
Thank you.
Sir, could you repeat your answer? We did not hear.
Sa sai som luk chlai lang veng jeung khnyom sdap at ton nei chmlai robas luk.
Som som ra pe ra tram ban. Mong ve tam si ra tram ban.
Well, let me move on to another question. Do you ever recall
Sao Pim
saying that he was concerned about these arrests, that these were loyal people, not traitors who were being arrested? Do you recall Sao Pim being hospitalized in Phnom Penh in early 1978?
Sao Pim got thrown out of the hospital in Phnom Penh in 1978.
And was he staying in Phnom Penh being treated? Can you tell us what you know about his illness? Did you ever see or hear what the problem was?
Do
you recall if during the time that he was in Phnom Penh, in the hospital, Isom cadre were being arrested back in the Isom? Thank you. Let me just read something from P3/1593, that's Kiernan, at 0115023 English, in French 00639172, and in Khmer at 00637947. He wrote that Pim's March-April illness and his absence from the East proved crucial as his suspicions were justified. He came home not fully recovered, defying his own administration under withering center attack. By 19 April, no fewer than 409 Isom cadres were being held in Tuslang. The largest number from any other zone was 48 from the northwest. The 28 new prisoners who entered Tuslang on 20 April were all from the east. So, sir, this writer was talking about East zoners being arrested and taken to Phnom Penh in April 1978. Did you witness that or learn anything about East zoners being taken by the center under arrest to Phnom Penh?
จับคลุนอยู่มาพนมเปญได้หรือเต
้ยังบังดังได้ความดังลืมยังบัดดังจากนอนบัดเนาะดังใจนาวนานที่จับดังนบัดเนาะมันไปจับในน้ำในน้ำยังหมดยังที่มีโยธาตานยังหมดยังไงปัดน้ำปัดห้องเนี่ยจากนอน
And did you learn why they were being arrested?
តើលោកដឹងទេហេតុអ្វីបានជាគេចាប់ខ្លួនពួកគាត់
ខ្ញុំមិនដឹងដែរមិនដឹងមិនដឹង
I'd like to read to you something from the same author on the same page where he talks about the meeting that Sao Phem was at in Punia Creek District Office in Ha'ol Village in March 1978. The author quotes this woman as saying, I was serving the food for the leading cadre there, but I went in close and heard what was being said.Khmer told them that the situation had now changed considerably and the comrades should all take an interest. He reminded the regional and district cadre of this standpoint because the regional, district, and military cadres were being taken away one after another everywhere. When he noticed this, he said that those arrested were loyal servants of the people.His friends, not traitors. He told everyone to watch out to be careful. Do you recall whether Sao Phem in these early arrests was cooperating with the center? Or was he concerned? Did you ever see him express any opinion about these arrests?
Bác
nhận
đăng đi.
Bác nhận đăng đi.
Bác nhận đăng đi.
Okay, thank you. I'm going to move on to a new topic.
So, my friend, I don't need to know that I want to talk about the new topic. I want to talk about the new topic. I want to talk about the new topic.
The new topic I want to talk about.
I'm just standing to provide the answer to the question of Justice Vernon's president. It was indeed Todd who said this. Todd was the adopted son of William and a high-ranking member of the Northwest Zone military staff in E3/9610 at question and answer 28. He said that Dahoon was the chief of Sector 5.
ឆ្នាំលេខាតំបន់5ហើយឆ្នាំហើយជាលហើយប៉ុលគឺជាអនុ
Asked the same question on the 6th of July 2015
before the Supreme Court of F1.1 he said that 939
Perhaps be the chief of Sector 5.
បាទសូមបញ្ជាក់ជាភាសាខ្មែរទាត់ហ្នឹងគឺទាត់ធឿនណាហើយអង់គ្លេសហៅថាទាត់ហ្នឹងតកូលខ្មែរមិនយល់ទេណាបាទអង្គជំរះអរគុណលោកស័ក្តិសីហើយសក្តិកម្មរបស់លោកមិនទាន់ចប់ទេហើយឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃត្រង់ហើយលោកអាចសម្រាកបានហើយហើយចាំម៉ោង1កន្លះជួបគ្នានៅកន្លែងសូមអញ្ជើញលោកមកផ្ដល់មកអង្គុយនៅកន្លែងផ្ដល់សិក្ខាកម្មនោះដើម្បីបន្តការផ្ដល់សិក្ខាកម្មតទៅទៀតហើយរួមទាំងថាមន្ត្រីប្រឹក្សាសាស្ត្រ័យផងលោកមឿនតវ័នលោកថាសិចដាប់បានទេបាទតាមបានលោកសម្រាប់បានហើយណាចាំម៉ោង1កន្លះជួបគ្នាទៀតបាទហើយអង្គជំរះសូមជម្រាបជូនដំណឹងដល់ភិក្ខីនិងសាធារណជនជាផងដែរថាសាក់សី PTTW 971ដែលសកម្មភាពស្ដាប់សាក់សីរំលឹកកាលថ្ងៃទី9ខែធ្នូឆ្នាំ2016มันអាចប្រព្រឹត្តទៅបានដោយសារបញ្ហាអ៊ីនធឺណិតនោះអង្គជំរះនឹងធ្វើសកម្មភាពស្ដាប់បន្តស្ដាប់សកម្មភាពរបស់គាត់តាមរយៈប្រព័ន្ធទូរទស្សន៍ពីខេត្តឧត្តរមានជ័យនៅថ្ងៃប្រហ័សទី15ធ្នូឆ្នាំ2016
ហើយមុននឹងសម្រាប់អាហារថ្ងៃត្រង់នេះអង្គជំរះក៏សម្រេចចេញរិទ្ធិទទួលមត់លើសំណើសុំពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងអ្នកជំនាញដែលមានហត្ថលេខាពី TCE 1064អនុលោមតាមវិធាន 80 4នៃវិធានទីក្នុងអង្គជំរះយោងទៅស្រីសន្តិធម្មតលមត់ដែលបានធ្វើឡើងកັບថ្ងៃទី 7 ខែធ្នូឆ្នាំ 2016 តេតិននឹងសំណើរបស់សហប្រាជ្ញាសូមឲ្យអង្គជំរះទទួលយកឯកសារចំនួន3ធ្វើជាឯកសារផ្ដាងអនុលោមតាមវិធាន 80 4នៃវិធានទីក្នុងសហប្រាជ្ញាបានលើកឡើងថាឯកសារទាំងនេះពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងអ្នកជំនាញពី TCE 1064ដែលនឹងមកផ្ដល់ទៅខែកម្មនាពេលខាងមុខភាគីផ្សេងទៀតនៃដំណំរឿងក្តីនេះពុំបានចំទាស់ទៅនឹងសំណើសុំនីតិអង្គជំរះសន្និដ្ឋានថាឯកសារដំបូងចំនួន 2ដែលរួមមានរបាយការណ៍ 1នឹងយ៉ាក្រាម 1ពីព័ត៌មានអំពីអតិធិធិតរបស់ជនរងគ្រោះដែលបានរក្សាទុកនៅជើងឯកត្រូវបានរៀបចំឡើងដោយអ្នកជំនាញពី TCE 1062 ហើយឯកសារនេះមានទំនាក់ទំនងយ៉ាងជិតស្និទ្ធទៅនឹងសក្ខីកម្មរបស់អ្នកជំនាញរូបនេះហេតុនេះឯកសារនេះត្រូវបានទទួលយកធ្វើជាឯកសារភស្តុតាងអនុលោមតាមវិធាន 84 នៃវិធានទីក្នុងឯកសារទី3គឺកំណត់ហេតុនៃការស្ដាប់ចម្លើយរបស់សាក្សីមួយរូប ដែលបានផ្ដល់ទៅខេកកម្មក្នុងសំណុំរឿងនេះរួចហើយហើយនេះឯកសារនេះក៏គួរត្រូវបានយកជាឯកសារភស្តុតាងផងដែរស្របតាមការអនុវត្តកន្លងមករបស់អង្គជំរះដើម្បីអាចវាតម្លៃទៅលើសក្ខីកម្មរបស់សាក្សីបានពេញលេញអង្គជំរះហេតុនេះអង្គជំរះទទួលយកឯកសារទាំងនេះតាមសំណើសុំរបស់សាប្រាជ្ញានិងដាក់លេខឯកសម្គាល់ឯកសារដូចតទៅឯកសារ E3/10765/2064ចំពោះឯកសារទី1ឯកសារ E3/10765/2ពួកឯកសារទី3សេចក្តីសម្រេចផ្ទាល់មាត់នេះគឺជាការឆ្លើយតបផ្លូវការរបស់អង្គជំរះទៅនឹងសំណើខាងលើបាទឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃត្រង់ហើយអញមានប្រកាសសម្រាប់ចាប់ពេលនេះទៅទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង1កន្លះរសៀលសូមអញ្ជើញយើងវិញដើម្បីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្រាប់ការ ហើយមិនប្រកបអានរិយអំពីគុំខាំងនាំខ្លួនលោកខៀវសំផនត្រឡប់ទៅកាន់បន្ទប់រងចាំខាងក្រោមសាលសន្និការនេះមិនប្រកបឲ្យនាំខ្លួនគាត់ត្រឡប់ចូលរួមសន្និការនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សន្និការនេះវិញនៅរសៀលនេះហាក់បានមុនម៉ោង1កន្លះសម្រាប់ចុះ